Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to make a subject in a photo appear to be looking through glass with the outside environment they're looking at appears to be reflected onto that glass. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, hit that subscribe button. Open a photo of someone or something whose background is black or mostly dark. The dark areas will show the outside environment the best. Open another photo that will become the outside environment. We'll place it onto our subject by pressing V to open the Move tool and dragging it onto the tab of our subject. Without releasing our mouse or pen, drag it down and release. Reduce its opacity so we can see our subject under it. To resize it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner. If you're using a version earlier than CC 2019, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. If you're using a later version, just press Alt or Option as you drag it. To reposition it, go inside the Transform's bounding box and drag your image. To accept its size and position, press Enter or Return twice, or click the check mark at the top. I'll cancel it since I previously sized and positioned it. Increase its opacity back to 100%. We'll convert the photo into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. If your entire photo is in focus, as in this example, we'll need to create a blur that'll blur it the further it is from our vantage point. If your photo already has a depth of field blur, the next step isn't necessary. If it's not blurred, go to Filter, Blur Gallery, and Tilt Shift. If it's grayed out, go to Image, Mode, RGB Color, and 8 bits per channel. If you don't see Tilt Shift in the list, go to Edit, Preferences, Plugins, and show all filter gallery groups and names. Once Tilt Shift opens, if you don't see the lines or blur ring, just click your image. I did an in-depth tutorial on Tilt Shift, so if you want to watch it, I provided its link as well. Basically, in a nutshell, the area between the solid lines is sharp. The areas between the solid lines and the dashed lines transition the photo from sharp to the maximum blur that we set for it. The areas outside the dashed lines are fully blurred based on how much the blur ring is rotated or the amount of blur in the blur tools. Since I'd like to start the blur way at the bottom, I'll go to the center pin and drag it down, which drags the entire tilt shift with it. If you want to transition the blur more gradually, drag the feather line up. As I mentioned, you can adjust the amount of blur by dragging the blur ring counterclockwise or clockwise. If there are areas of the background in the distance that intersect areas in the foreground, as with the bridge and fence rails in this photo, I'll show you how to deal with that in a moment. But first, click OK at the top to accept the tilt shift. Notice that the smart filter comes with a layer mask. If we brush black over the layer mask, those black areas will reveal the photo in its original unblurred state. But before we brush black over it, we need to make the layer mask active. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Pick a soft, round brush. We'll take care of the size in a moment. The hardness is 0%. Reduce its opacity to approximately 35% and keep the flow at 100%. In case you're wondering what the difference is between opacity and flow, while opacity controls the transparency of the paint, flow controls the speed at which the paint is laid down. In this particular case, the flow is 100%. However, when the flow is less than 100%, we can gradually build up our darkest color by doing multiple passes in the same area, much like painting with a spray paint can. To make your brush bigger or smaller, make sure your caps lock key is off and press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Brush over the areas of the foreground that are blurry to gradually reveal back the original focused photo. Next, we'll blur our overall image a bit more, but before we do, make the photo active and convert it into a smart object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. blurred 3 pixels. Next, if you're using CC, we'll increase the color contrast. Go to Filter and Camera Raw Filter. If you're using a version later than CC 2017, open Basic and slide Dehaze to the right. If you're using an earlier version, the Dehaze filter is under Effects. Temporarily hide the reflection background and make your subject active. Convert it into a smart object and go to Image, Adjustments, and Shadows Highlights. Shadows Highlights does many things, but it's mainly used to brighten dark areas, some of which may be hidden in shadows. To see all the options in this filter, check Show More Options. Since every photo has its own characteristics of shadows, highlights, and midtones, feel free to adjust these settings. For this photo, I'll make the shadows amount 35%, the shadow tone 50%, and the radius 30 pixels. For the rest of the settings, I'll keep its default amounts. Next, we'll copy the Dehaze Camera Raw filter and apply it to our subject. To do this, go to the Camera Raw Smart Filter and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it next to your subject. Make the top layer visible and change its blend mode to Screen. I'll reduce its opacity to 70%, but feel free to adjust it to an opacity that looks good to you. Lastly, we'll adjust the color cast of the subject so it matches more closely to our background that's reflected on the surface of the window. Make the subject active and click the adjustment layer icon. Click Photo Filter. For this image, I'll use Warming Filter 85 and increase its density to 64%. Again, pick a color filter that closely matches the color cast of your image. As I toggle before and after, you can see the difference. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.